नमस्कार. गजाली या कार्यक्रमाक तुमकां सगळ्यांक येवकार. आज आमच्या मदीं अशी एक साहित्यीक आसा जिच्या बद्दल खूब थोड्या जाणांक खबर आसा. खूब थोड्या जाणांक खबर आसा इतल्या खातीर की तिजी पुस्तकां ही इंग्लीश भाशेंत बरयल्या आनी ताका लागून कांय ठराविक लोकांनी ती वाचल्यांत. पूण ह्या बायलेन जी पुस्तकां बरयल्या ही सगळीं गोंया बद्दल बरयल्या. चार पुस्तकां बरयल्यान तातूंतली तीन गोंयाचेर आसात. ह्या बायलेचें आनी एक खाशेलपण म्हळ्यार चार पुस्तकांच बरोवन, तिनूच बरोवन, चवथें हालींच बरयलां, तिका पद्मश्री हो किताब फावो जाला. ज्या खूब थोड्या गोंयकारांक पद्मश्री मेळ्ळा तातूंत तिजेंय नांव आसा आनी तें एक साहित्यीक म्हणून तिका पद्मश्री मेळ्ळां हें खाशेलपण तिजें. ती अशी चड स्वताक फुडें फुडें करना, आपली पब्लिसिटी स्वता करून घेना, पूण आपलें जें काम आसा तें मात सामकें निश्ठेन करता, त्या कामाच्या प्रेमान करता. आनी म्हणून तिच्या हातांतल्यान जीं पुस्तकां बरोवन जाल्यां ह्या पुस्तकांक स्वताचो असो एक वेगळोच दर्जो आसा. आमचे मदीं आज आसा पद्मश्री मारिया आवरोरा कुटो. मारिया बाय,
नमस्कार.
नमस्कार. तुम्ही चार पुस्तकां बरयलीं. द लास्ट वन, द रिसंट वन दॅट वॉज पब्लिश्ड इज फिलोमेनास जर्नी, एन्ड देन यू हॅव सॅड इट इज अबावट अ फॅमिली, मॅरेज अँड कल्चर. नाव गोईंग बिफोर गोईंग टू द बूक, कॅन यू जस्ट टॅल अज अबावट युअर फॅमिली बॅकग्राऊंड?
फस्ट पयलें म्हाका सांगूंक जाय तुका की आमचें म्हजें पयलें पुस्तक, पयलें म्हणल्यार जें गोंयचें पुस्तक डॉक्टर स्टोरी कोंकणी अकादमीन कोंकणींत केलां, पूण हेदुसान भायर सरलो ना. इट इज इन द प्रेस, आय एम टोल्ड. माय फॅमिली बॅकग्राऊंड इज दॅट आय एम फ्रॉम सालसेत, फ्रॉम मारगांव प्रॉपर. आय वॉज बॉर्न इन मारगांव, माय फादर वॉज बॉर्न इन मारगांव, बट ही इज ओरिजिनली फ्रॉम लोथुली. I mean, it's a Lotuli family, the Figueiredos of Lotuli. And my mother comes from Raya. And when researching this particular book, although you haven't asked me about my book, I thought I might as well say that while I was researching the book, ma kollen ki mujhe pai sashti so mai sashti si dogai kristau puna their culture was widely different. There's the Margao urban semi lusophone culture, पोर्चुगीज बेस्ड, आनी मुगे आवयची रुरल एग्रीकल्चरल कम्युनिटी, लॉट ऑफ कोंकणी अलोंग वीथ पोर्चुगीज, वीच मेड अ बीग डिफरन्स टू देर पर्सनेलिटीज. तें म्हाका दिसता की यु नो द रुरल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ माय मदर वॉज वॉट वॉज द स्ट्रेंथ दॅट शी ब्रॉट टू हर मॅरेज.
आनी मागीर शिक्षण खंय जालें?
शिक्षण धाकटें आसतना गोवा मारगांव फस्ट स्टँडर्ड मे बी वेन आय वॉज सात वर्सांची आमी धारवाड गेलीं.
कित्याक? कित्याक?
फॉर एज्युकेशन. एन्ड देर वॉज अ प्रॉब्लम, तूं पुस्तक वाच, दॅट सिक्रेट वील नॉट बी रिवील्ड ऑन टेलिविजन. आनीक मागीर इट वॉज ऑल्सो अ व्हेरी वेल नोन प्लेस फॉर एज्युकेशन. आनी म्हजो पायचो फस्ट कजन फ्रांसिस्को रेफोंस, फ्रांसिस्को रफोंस आनी म्हजो पाय दोन भयणीचो भयणीचें पूत, आनी तीं दोनी भयण आसलीं, भाव नासलें आनी भयण नासली, सो दे वर व्हेरी क्लोज, द फॅमिलीज वर व्हेरी क्लोज. आनी फ्रांसिस्को रफोंस वॉज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कर्नाटक कॉलेज, एक्स्ट्रीमली वेल नोन कॉलेज एन्ड एक्स्ट्रीमली वेल नोन मॅन. आनीक तेन्ना तूं जाणा गोंयांत कॉलेज नाशिल्लीं, देर वर नो कॉलेजीस. एस एस सी पासून एग्जाम करूंक धारवाड बेळगांव बोंबय वयतलीं वयतालीं. So there was a large Goan Catholic student community in the colleges. So it was a natural progression for education, and but there were also family problems, and my mother went there really because it seemed an escape from a problematic situation in Margao, and there was the moral support of Francisco Rafons. The Beshti, she didn't go into a wilderness. She went where there was a moral support. So I think that was a great piece of good fortune.
And then you graduated from there.
I finished my high school, finished my graduation, finished my post-graduation, lectured at the college there, Karnataka College, for 2 years, at which time Armand Menezes was the principal.
Oh.
So I had him, I had Armand Menezes for 2 years when doing my master's degree, and then 2 years as my principal when I was teaching. And KJ Mahale was also my French professor from the age of 17 till I finished my master's. And in Zaiti going to Miss Virgin Kaur used to teach French there. So then I got married and went off to Patna. And I was there for just a year. And 6 months on Kazazatrich, there was liberation. June on Kazazalim, December was liberation. September 62, Amka Angadarling Goyan. Alban was specially chosen by the central government because he was a Goenkar. And because he was young. They wanted not very senior officer, but not very junior officer either, because it was a period of transition. So Amka Angadarli. And that for me, for Goa, it was a great piece of good fortune. When he died, when he passed away, Mario Cabral had a headline that Alban did more than anyone could possibly do for Goa and Goans at that period. He really, I mean, people who would tell you what he did would be people like Suresh Amonkar, Sridhar Tamba, you know, these people, even Dr. Dume, because Dr. Varde, his father-in-law, worked. But for me, it was a huge piece of good fortune for two reasons. One reason is that I got to see a spectrum of Goan society, a spectrum of Goan communities, not Salset, not Bardes, not Christian, not Hindu, you know, beyond class, caste, everything. That I think was brilliant. Otherwise, these books would not have happened. I'm looking at Goa because Goa was revealed to me when I was very young. And it's not as though I was thinking of writing. You know, I was just 24, 25 years old and I had a six-month-old baby. But I was absorbing, you know, I was absorbing this richness of Goa, traveling all over the place, meeting all kinds of people. And that my great good fortune is that na melen ten lokachi dost amizad Rauli. Those connections deepened over time. Aniata, their children, their grandchildren are part of my family, whatever the community. That is why Sogla Lok Mutalo, for your release, how did you get so many people? I said, I didn't go collecting them. They're all on my computer. They're dost, you know, they're families. I've known their grandchildren, or the grandfathers also. So I think that was a great gift. And I said it at the release, that if I hadn't come to Goa at that time in that position, and it's, I don't mean position of power. I mean a way in which I could establish a social network that cut across all Goan divides. For me, Goa is not divided. That's why that release showed that there was no division. Soglimuntai, that is what everyone is telling me. It's a Goa without division. I said, for me, Goa is without division. My sadness is this terrible division that's going on, getting worse, if you ask me. And in Dusri Vosti is that there was no one to teach literature in Tempe College. College had started. Mr. Couto was in charge of education. And so, you know, Professor Lavande and the others used to come a lot to discuss. And they discovered that I had not only a first class degree, but I had 2 years experience. And he, please come and teach. Murlagle. I mean, I had this great good fortune of having the principal come to the house and say, please come and teach. And there was only one person, Lucio Rodrigues, senior, retired man. And I, completely junior, okay. And so I said that I have a six-month-old baby, you know, it's difficult. And he said, no, you do only 8 classes a week. And then Mr. Couto, you know, at that time, we were so careful. He said, I can't allow her to do this because this is, education is under me. And the press will say this is favoritism. At that time, I mean, always, Mr. Couto was always very, very correct. But at that time, you had to be super careful because there were a lot of, there was an antagonism about these, you know, bail sanela, amche, ek raj gela and dusra raj ela, you know, that was the kind of sense you had. And for Mr. Couto as a Goan, it was very difficult because he, for him, this was home, you know, and he wanted everything to be smooth and easy and accepted. So he was saying no, and I was lucky to have a very, modern, ambitious father-in-law who said, no, she has to go. And I'm not going back to Bombay until she joins. And you cannot disobey your father. So it was quite a drama. So then he wrote to the governor.
Oh.
Yeah. Mr. Couto was very correct. He wrote to the governor saying that my wife has been asked to join the MP college because there are no other people and she's completely eminently qualified. But education is under me and I'm not sure whether it's the right thing to do. So Shivashankar was the first lieutenant governor of Goa and he said, this is ridiculous. She's qualified and if there was an interview and there were other candidates, I'm sure she would have qualified. So there's no question about her. You needing permission, she should join immediately. Do you know, Dr. Vaidya, he let me join on condition that I didn't get a salary, only an honorarium. So some sort of honorarium was given, Mahugrasna. And when I left, I was given a lovely Kanjivaram sari and a dining tablecloth. But, I feel very often that if that first step hadn't been taken after I got married, I'm not sure whether it would have been so easy for me to just decide that I want to go back and start applying and all that. Then when we moved to Delhi, and it became a natural move towards
regarding this about Mr. Couto, I want to ask you one thing. See, tujhe kulara ashilli palatun tena avai and others who were there, they always encouraged you. Pahilecha tashe asta gharakade astana avai bapu khub encouragement dita kazar jaun Goa ger geli, it's many a times her legs are pulled.
Not in my case.
Yeah. How was Mr. Couto regarding you as a careeristic woman in his life?
He was very proud of my mind. He always said from the time we got to know each other and got married, he said, I don't want you to allow your mind to rust. He wasn't particularly anxious that I should have work and earn money and that sort of professional life he wasn't looking at all. But he was absolutely determined that I should step out of the house and go to libraries. I mean, don't let your mind rust. Mm. And that is why, as I keep telling to everybody, I consider myself very lucky to have done what I've done because I never had an ambition for a career. I never chose to do lecturer, then professor, then head of department. That kind of progression was not part of my life at all. I mean, that was not part of my thinking. I wanted to be a very good teacher and a very good mother, wife. The home was important. Mm. My classroom was important. And so I never went the career way. I never even bothered about all this business. I didn't even do seminars, conferences, because I had no time. Burgi, ani good teaching. And I must have been a very good teacher because I have lots of students who are now teaching in America. Some of them are in Europe. Many are in Delhi. Some are in Chennai. They all keep in touch. At least a dozen of them have come to Aldona. Even yesterday, one of them rang me up from San Francisco. You see, when they read something interesting, they ring me up. And the best part of it is that when this book, two of my students, one in Delhi and one in America, read all the drafts, gave me suggestions. So I think that's something so rewarding, very rewarding.
Yeah.
And it didn't matter that I didn't become a professor. So anga soglang munna amaka professor munna ka, you just call me Dr. Couto at the most. Even my PhD, I did not because I wanted a promotion, but because Mr. Couto was sent as Commissioner Patna Division during the JP agitation.
Oh.
And JP was in Bihar, in Patna. In fact, he took me to meet JP. It's one of the great memories of my life. So he was transferred to Patna and the chief secretary said, please don't resign, do something, keep your job. So then I took study leave and that's when I did my PhD.